In the last couple of weeks, the world of sport has been rocked by allegations, even confessions, of the Australian cricket team tampering with the ball in a match with South Africa. But in this video, we're going to look at the origins of the sport of cricket and of the name itself. So where did the name cricket actually come from? Well, for many years, the name and the sport appear to have originated in Saxon or Norman times by children living in the Weald in England. The Saxons were a group of Germanic tribes of what is now Germany, and they settled England in the Middle Ages. The Normans were people from what is Normandy in France, and they migrated to England around the time of the Norman conquest, roughly the latter part of the 11th century. The Weald is an area of southeast England, and it was here that the name and the sport seems to have been used first. Now, there are a number of words that are thought to be the possible sources for the term cricket. The name may have been derived from the Middle Dutch krik, meaning a stick, or the Old English krik or kruis, meaning a crutch or staff. Another possible source is the Middle Dutch word krikstoel, meaning a long low stool used for kneeling in church. And it has some resemblance to the long low wicket and two stumps used in early cricket. One more obscure possible source was proposed by the European language expert Heiner Gilmeister of the Bonn University, and he proposed that the name cricket comes from the Middle Dutch phrase for hockey, met de krik ketsen, which means with the stick chase. Now, it's quite likely that cricket was devised originally by children and probably survived for many generations as essentially a children's game. Adult participation is unknown before the early 17th century. Now, possibly cricket was derived from bowls, if we assume that bowls is the oldest sport, by the intervention of a batsman trying to stop the ball from reaching the target by hitting it away. The first definite mention of the game is found in a 1598 court case concerning an ownership dispute over a plot of common land in Guildford, Surrey. A 59-year-old coroner, John Derrick, testified that he and his school friends had played cricket on the site 50 years earlier when they attended the free school there. Derrick's account proves beyond reasonable doubt that the game was being played in Surrey around 1550. The first reference to cricket being played as an adult sport was in 1611, when two men in Sussex were prosecuted for playing cricket on a Sunday instead of going to church. In the last couple of years, however, it may appear it's actually the French who should get credit for the name and the sport. In a letter to King Louis XI from around 1478, it may contain the first known reference to cricket or criquet. Now, the letter itself was penned by a young man called Estevenet, who was watching with fascination at a strange game before a player barked, "Why are you staring at our ball?" or "Why are you staring at our ball game?" A violent scuffle ensued and one man died. Now, whatever its origins, it's true that the English who are the ones who really embraced it as the sport we know today. Cricket was introduced to North America via the English colonies around the 17th century, probably before it even reached the north of England. In the 18th century, it arrived in other parts of the globe too. It was introduced to the West Indies by colonists and to India by the British East India Company mariners in the first half of that century. It arrived in Australia almost as soon as colonisation began in 1788. New Zealand and South Africa followed in the early years of the 19th century. Now, the basic rules for cricket, such as the bat and ball, the wicket, pitch dimensions, overs, how you got out, etc., have existed since time immemorial. But in 1728, the Duke of Richmond and Alan Brodick drew up articles of agreement to determine the code of practice in a particular game. And this became a common feature, especially around payment of stake money and also distribution of the winnings, given the importance of gambling at the time. In 1744, the laws of cricket were codified for the first time and then amended in 1774 when innovations such as LBW, the middle stump, the maximum bat width were added. Now, these laws stated that the principal shall choose from among the gentlemen present two umpires who shall absolutely decide all disputes. The codes were drawn up by the so-called Star and Garter Club, whose members ultimately founded the MCC at Lord's in 1787. Now, the MCC immediately became the custodian of the laws, and it has made periodic revisions and recodifications subsequently. So, ultimately, we may never quite know where the name came from definitively, but we can say it was the English who were the ones who made it into the sport as it's played today. So, join me next time as we explore yet more why, what, where, who, when, and how questions. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button below, and please send me a comment, question, or topic suggestion, as always, to 5Ws and 1H at gmail.com, and I'll say bye-bye for now.